I had a great mentor growing up. His name was Dr. Ron Surfoss, and he was a fantastic optometrist. And every time I would go in, he was always he enjoyed his life so much, and I always wanted to know what it was that he loved about it. I fell in love with this profession and knowing how much I can change someone's life.
When I was born, I knew that healthcare was something I really wanted to be a part of. You could just see the impact that it had on people's lives and how much of a role you can play in someone's life and their healthcare and just really making sure that they're living their absolutely best life.
In my years at University of Texas in my undergrad, I actually got to volunteer at the Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired, and I got to meet this little girl, and she was reading the book from a Braille. So she literally took my hand one day and she was like, "Sandy, I am stuck, I don't know how to do this." And literally, you know, from the moment that she grabbed onto my hand, that's when I realized I need to have a different approach.
So I was looking into different medical fields in undergrad, med school, dentistry, and optometry. And I just feel like optometry would allow me to be a doctor, help patients, allow me to have a comfortable lifestyle, and enough flexibility to have a family, which has always been a top priority for me.
I did graphic design as well in undergrad, and I really just like designing in general, and I think that even though people need glasses to see and it helps their visual health, they can also use it to make a fashion statement. And especially for young teenagers and children, it helps to have glasses that help them but also looks really cute. It makes them actually want to wear it like they're supposed to.
Our school just opened a new clinical skills lab, and it's basically like a virtual simulator of how a real practice is. So all the new technology, all the EHRs, all the equipment is brand new, and we also have a virtual lab.
I would like to specialize in vision therapy and pediatrics. I really like kids, so I'd really like to work with them, and I like how vision therapy helps to take the vision you already have and make it better.
Optometry school is definitely demanding, and when you're an undergrad, if you take on extracurricular activities, I believe that helps you manage your time better and be able to prepare for what you do after undergrad. You have to be committed and responsible and just do something that you love, and then when you do something that you love, you'll do whatever you can to make it work.
We spent a week in Honduras, and we were just in a very remote village, and we were just giving eye exams. We probably saw about 200 patients in 4 days. That was remarkable. I really enjoyed it.
Some of the things at UAB we do, one thing is called Blazer Vision, and it's with the football team, and now they're expanding it to all the sports teams, so it's concussion studies. And so there's designing of new helmets based on all this new technology and results from the studies, and then so all the impact, and then also how vision testing can tell how soon a player can get back on the field.
I would like to go back to my home state in Tennessee and be in a private practice and eventually own, and I could be a doctor and business owner.
I think I want to do a residency as well and maybe even get to live in another state for a year. I think that would be a good opportunity to do that.
I've always looked to making a difference in people's lives. As I said, I knew that I wanted to be in the medical field to some capacity. My dad is actually a physician, so again, I knew that medicine was something that I wanted to do because it helps so many people.
Visit an optometrist. Talk to me, talk to others, and let them share with you how optometry can let you balance work and life. Somebody asked me, says, "Wouldn't you have wanted to be an ophthalmologist or whatever?" I said, "You know, if you know my background, I'm so happy to be where I am."